All right, today I'm gonna give you guys a detailed look at this Robocop set. This is the one with the chair, and this is by Hot Toys. And let's start off with what kind of accessories that this Robocop comes with. First, it comes with the base, not your standard base, but more of a Terminator base, Terminator style base, and no light up. And then here's one, the data spike hand, then two fists, and then he comes with two pistols. One is your regular plastic one with the moving slide and removable magazine. Oh wow, this one is the die cast one, no moving parts. And then here we have the remote for the audio for Robocop. And this here, it's the tool for you to open up the back panel on Robocop. And three mouthpieces. And then here we have a battle damage helmet and a battle damage chest and his chair. Alright, so here we have Robocop. Let's take a good look at him from the front. And he has articulated fingers. There he is. Front view. Here's a side view. See the helmet has the OCP Police 001. And joints, they do have rubber pieces covering them. Same with the knees. And here we have the back side of Robocop. And here, you might not be able to pick up through the camera here. On this, the shoulder area, they did do a little minor paint on it. Where they did a little bit of a bluish tint to it. And same with the back of the helmet. Back of his head, you can see there's a little tiny hint of a bluish tint on there. I don't know why they did that, but not the rest of the figure. Alright, I was lucky enough to be able to check out six of these guys, and out of six of them, I was able to find one that was pretty much perfect. The rest of them all has minor defects here and there. One I saw has a little, this line right here was not filled in properly. And then some of them got scuff marks on the helmet, some on this side. And then one I saw was right there in the center, some plastic flashing that they didn't remove them properly. And then a few of them got chest scratches on some certain areas, and a lot of defects that I don't know why or how they got through quality control, but they're actually out there. So if you're buying the one with the chair, I hope that you get to pick them out or look through them. If not, then I suggest buying them through a Sideshow so you could at least get a replacement piece, because a lot of the damages are from the helmet and the removable chest piece. And the single figure, the one that does not come with a chair, I found them to be a little bit better as far as quality control. I don't know why the ones with the chair has more problems than the ones that are without the chair. Alright, articulation for Robocop, it's a lot like Mark 42, where the arm could actually pull out. You could extend out the arm a little bit. Right there, you can see. Alright, where's my thing? Right there, you can extend out while this side is pushed in. And there's a ball joint in there. And same thing with the abdominal area. This you could pull up, and then it'll give you a little more range of motion around this section right here. And the legs, you can all, actually they suggest you pull out. You can pull out and up a little bit. and then gives you a little more range of motion for when he's sitting mainly. And yeah, so those are the added articulation to this figure. And to switch out the mouthpiece and the chest piece, all you have to do on the helmet, basically all you have to do is lift up the helmet. It's magnetized, and then all you have to do is just pull the face out. And with the chest piece, there are two magnets right there. They're in there. And then just need to pull this out and then switch in your battle damage plate. And here we have Robocop with the battle damage helmet and battle damage chest piece. It looks pretty cool. And here, switch out the mouthpiece. You see it's he's in pain right now. Alright, and here we have Robocop sitting in his chair, and he is having a bad dream right now. On the back right there, there are two lights back there. And here I got the angry mouthpiece on, and the clean helmet and the clean chest plate. So here you can see he is having a bad dream. I love this chair. If you're on the fence about getting either the Robocop standalone or get the chair, I say get the chair because if you plan on getting the other Robocop, the battle damage Robocop with Murphy, then this would be a good second piece for it, because it's not just another Robocop standing up. You can have this one sitting down while the other one standing up, and the Murphy as well. So having the chair gives it a little more option for you, especially for photography. And even on display, I wouldn't mind displaying him this way. Most people would probably display him standing up. That would be it, but this is a nice option for you. And here you see a little monitor with a Robocop in it. Detailing on this, it's really, really good. You do get to apply the sticker on yourself, and you can see I messed up. Mine's a little slanted on the top one, the bottom one is fine, but the top one is a little crooked. And some of these, let's take a look at the back. Well, let's take a look at the side first. Here. See, there are wires still attached to the bags. Still inside the bag here. Because I never did take it out. Well, basically, you just need to plug that on the bottom of the chair. Yeah, overall, it's a great looking chair. This section here, the grayish black section, it's where all the weight is, because it has to compensate for the Robocop sitting in there. And this headrest, it's kind of cool. It's got plexiglass, and you can see inner workings of it. That's kind of neat. So yeah, there are wires running everywhere, and you just need to undo this wire. And also for the monitor, and I think they both go underneath the chair as well. But yeah, great, great looking chair. And there are articulations on this chair. Nothing around the seat itself. It doesn't tilt forward and back or anything like it did in the movie. There's a hinge right there, and then this one could rotate. And same with this monitor, it could swing forward and back. These buttons on top, they don't work. And the support on this thing, I've been asking a lot of people, but no one actually replied to my comment when I asked about the chair. And how they construct this, the construction of this is that there's a rod that runs into here. It's kind of like a peg, where when you press this button, it removes, it unhooks, and you could pull this whole thing out, which I'll show you guys. And after you press the button, you could remove this whole chair off the stand with So this thing basically plugs into it and it snaps together. You'll hear it click, and here there's a little peg here. But yeah, this piece of plastic is definitely enough to support this whole chair up with the figure in it, and you shouldn't have to worry about having your RoboCop sitting in the chair while on display. And here I got him back on resting mode, and he's sleeping now. So yeah, again, the chair, it's fine, no problems whatsoever, and that peg is definitely enough for you to hold, enough to support the weight of this figure. And one thing that's unfortunate is that while the pistol is in the holster, the thigh covering will not close properly, so you'll have to take out the pistol before you close out this this panel here. And here's a height comparison between RoboCop and Ed 209. As you can see, Ed 209 towers over him, as he should. And yeah, they are definitely in scale with each other. So yeah, very nice. So overall, I highly recommend this RoboCop. And if you could splurge for the chair, I say get it. Because that is a nice accessory for RoboCop. And yeah, it does cost a little over 100 for the chair itself. But I think it's worth it if you're getting the other RoboCop as well. Because that way, again, you can display this with the chair while the other battle damage with Murphy. So yeah, chair, it's well constructed, and no die-cast pieces that I know of, but still, I say it's worth getting, and because you do get to pose him while he's sitting in the chair. That's a really nice option. So yeah, highly recommend this RoboCop, and yeah, Baja Toys. Thanks for watching.